Hi guys, okay, so I am back after a bit of a break. Actually, I had contracted a viral fever because it's the rainy season here in India, and I just had fever, so I have just recovered, you know, from it, and so I'm back. I think in the next couple of days I'll be much, much better. So I wanted to do the reading today because it's been a while and I have the energy and I really got a push to, you know, like give some messages. It's been quite a while. So I think that this is definitely something that spirit wants me to do today. Okay. So in front of you are three stones. The first one is the blue calcite, light blue color. The second pile is the clear quartz. And the third one is the green jasper or the Kambaba jasper. It's a dark green stone. Okay. I will be putting up a clearer thumbnail so that you can easily choose the stone. Okay. Now, I want you to pause your videos and pick your stone from here if you want it or from the thumbnail. Okay, so pile one with the blue calcite. What message does spirit want to give you today? King of Cups, Two of Pentacles, Nine of Swords. Okay, we have Page of Wands here at the bottom. Okay, and we are having at the top the Nine of Pentacles. Okay, now I'm going to clarify this a little bit. Six of Pentacles, Two of Pentacles, and a Seven of Wands. Five of Pentacles. Okay, all right. I want to clarify the crowning and the underlying energy as well. So please clarify Nine of Pentacles. We have King of Wands. All right. We have Nine of Swords. Okay, all right. So what is the message for you, pile number one? Okay, if I were to, I'm going to give you a summary because I have the crowning as well as the underlying energies here. You need to be confident about whatever it is that you guys are contemplating at this time. Okay, For some of you, this is I'm getting, this is something like a message, okay? With the Page of Wands and the Knight of Swords, I feel there's some sort of a message that you want to send, okay? Some communication. Communication, message, okay? Either you guys want to send that, or you're waiting for that, or you're contemplating it, you know, thinking about it a lot, overthinking about it, you know? There's a sense of hurry here as well. However, I do see confidence as well. Okay, like you will do this. Okay, you know that you will do this. All right, that's the current energy. However, when I come here with, you know, to the King of Cups and the Six of Pentacles, I'm getting one is that maybe you are planning to send a message. Okay. Yeah, I am getting some communication message, you know, like really fast, okay, really soon, all right. Big hurry I'm sensing here, okay, to send this. Now, with the King of Cups and the Six of Pentacles, I feel that you want to give something with a lot of emotion to someone, okay. This could be a gift, this could be a job, this could be a sum of money, this could be just anything, guys, okay? And it is with a lot of emotion and sincerity, okay? I am not seeing you guys perturbed about it or confused about it in any way, all right? You want to give this, you're very clear and you're very calm about it, okay? I do feel you've been like collecting, or you've been like preparing to give something to someone, probably someone who needs it, I'm not sure, okay? But you are very sure about it, you're very calm about it. And if you're not, spirit is asking you to please be very confident about it, okay? Very calm about it, very confident about it. In fact, I think this might be some sort of an, for some of you it might be an expression of love as well. You know, like how we gift our loved ones with gifts or something. I'm getting that kind of a sense here, that, you know, some of you want to give something with a lot of heartfelt emotion, okay? And spirit is saying that, you know, like you need to be confident about this, all right? Because with the Two of Pentacles, Seven of Wands, Nine of Swords, Five of Pentacles, like I'm seeing you guys are getting into overthinking, anxiousness, worry, you know, like resistance, back and forth, okay? All of those energies are like, you are very clear that you want to do it, okay? However, like, you know, the sense I'm having is cold feet. You know, like, I think you guys are like, you know, like going back and forth, and it's even possible you're resisting it. For some of you, I'm getting that maybe you guys have worked very hard, you know, to give this gift. Maybe you've fought off people's opinions. There have been Herculean odds that you have crossed, pile number one, all right, to give this to someone, okay, to give this gift to someone, all right. And like, why would you think that this is not gonna go your way, okay? Or why are you worrying about it is what I'm getting, okay? Like, maybe I'm also getting another message that maybe there's just a few more you know, like tangles, I would say. So there's few more little obstacles, you know, that you might have to maneuver, maybe for next 2 days or 2 weeks, maybe, I don't know, okay? But you're gonna come clear. You're a warrior, pile one, okay? You guys are King of Wands. Okay, you guys are King of Wands, King of Cups. Beautiful, you know, like energy here, okay? So I'm getting you worked hard for something. You are going to get it. It's going to be really good, in fact, okay? All of your hard work, your perseverance, you know, your managing, you know, running back and forth, and I'm just getting so much work that you have done, it's going to pay off like big time, okay? That's the second message. The first message I'm getting is that, you know, like either you are giving a gift to someone which you have been preparing, okay, or you're getting a gift. I mean, like, apply it as it fits. I'm mostly getting that, you know, someone here who's very beautiful, emotionally mature energy wants to give something to someone, this could be you or someone else, okay, apply as fits. This is going to happen. There is some sort of a beautiful gift coming in or being given by someone very amazing, okay? And the second message I'm getting is that whatever obstacles you are facing right now, whether it's related to this or whether it's related to something else, okay, you are going to cross it, okay? And very soon. Like I am getting that you have a lot of light within you, okay? Spirit is your guardian. Spirit is the one watching over this. So please do not worry. You will cross any obstacles in the next 2 days or max 2 weeks. I don't know. It could even be 2 months, but I don't know. The sense I'm getting is like, you know, like 2 weeks or 2 days maybe. Right? You are going to, this is, you know, you need to maneuver a little bit in terms of this time. Okay? And the third message that I was getting over here is that if you guys are going back and forth in terms of whatever this giving is, okay, or even getting for that matter, okay, you know, you might be a bit back and forth about it, resistant about it, you know, because it's like cold feet, okay, but spirit is telling you not to really go into that too much. Fight it off. Fight off your dilly-dallying, all right? Like, you might come across a time when, like, let's just take an example. First example is if you're giving something to someone, you might be a bit back and forth about, like, when should I do it? How should I do it? Should I do it? You know, that kind of stuff. Okay, so spirit is saying that, you know, just fight this off. Fight off this tendency to have cold feet. Okay, now if you're getting a gift, all right, and it's like a really generous gift, you yourself might be a bit taken aback. You might become imbalanced, okay, and you might be like, oh my gosh, like, can I mean, do I really deserve this, you know, can I handle all this? You will. You'll be very effectively able to manage it, okay? So spirit is saying that fight off this energy of back and forth, dilly-dallying, unsurety. And that's the second message. Now the third message that I'm getting is, see, there is overthinking going on, okay? You guys are probably having worst case scenarios here, okay? That are you going to be rejected? What if you are rejected and, you know, like, hurt, rejected, you know, what if you're left out in the cold? Some of you are even having physical ailments that you're worried about. That's another message I'm getting. Okay, everything will be fine. Okay, everything is going to be fine, guys. Okay, this is just your overthinking. That's it. And I'm not sensing this as massive overthinking. I'm just seeing this as shadow of overthinking. Because, see, I see shadow of the swords here, right? So this is just shadows of overthinking. Maybe some of you are having insecurities, you know, about giving something to someone, about getting something from someone, you know, like there's just this sense of, like, you know, is this the right time? Am I good enough? How will it pan out? What if this happens? You know, all those kind of permutation combinations. Okay, spirit is saying, please don't worry. I'm also getting another message. If there is another person involved here, they're also going through that. Okay, they're also like, oh my gosh. You know, like, look at this owl, like, you know, like, they look a little gobsmacked. They're like, oh my gosh. So, guys, like, there's no need for all of this. This is just overthinking, all right? Dilly-dallying, overthinking, cold feet, all of that, okay? What is really going to happen is this Nine of Pentacles and King of Wands. Now, with Nine of Pentacles, it means, this means pride, accomplishment, okay, pride, accomplishment, feeling very, like, I don't know, in your power, okay? I am seeing that. This is how it's going to end, okay? All of this worry that you guys are having with respect to your situation, okay? It's all in vain, honestly speaking, you know, because you are coming up like this, pile number one, okay? This beautiful, proud bird, you know, full of, like, I mean, look at all the coins. Like, I'm also getting for some of you, there might be abundance involved here, okay? And with the King of Wands clarifying the Nine of Pentacles, like, you are going to be on top of your game, guys, okay? Once whatever this is that you have done, you guys are going to be so passionate. And even if, like, that is after you've done this, even before doing this, you will do this. serious like this, like you're going to be emphatic about it. You're going to be, you're very passionate about it, whatever this is, pile number one, okay? Like, you are not going to back down. Yeah, these are temporary fears that are coming up, and that is very normal, very human, okay? But your passion and your emotions are so strong that they will ensure a very happy conclusion to whatever this is that you guys are contemplating at this time. Okay, I'm seeing someone being very proud. I'm seeing someone being very passionate, very focused, and someone just looking at all of their accomplishments that they have done, that they have made, and feeling like a lot of pride, you know, about one own self. Okay, I do sense that even at this time, you know, you guys are in a very confident energy. I'm seeing confidence, like, you will do this, okay? These are just temporary things. You will do this, and this is going to turn out really well, okay? You're going to be proud of yourself. You're going to be proud of the conclusion that comes out of it, okay? I'm also getting, for some of you, you're going to be looking very good, okay? With the King of Wands and Nine of Pentacles, some of you are going to be, oh my gosh, like, all eyes are going to be on you, okay? So all of these all of these doubts and fears you're having are just temporary, you know, like the heebie-jeebies that you guys are getting, okay? There is no substance to these things at all. Spirit wants you to just calm down. Go with your emotions at this time. Go with the generosity of your emotions, with your heart, what you want to do, okay? And just go ahead and do it, like, that's what I'm getting, okay? You are going to be successful. Go ahead and do it, whatever this is. I think what's happening is maybe, you know, you guys are just waiting, okay, for this, for whatever this is to happen. And during the interim waiting time, you guys are going back and forth. You know, it's like before an exam, like, you've done all your studies and all of that. And then you have 2 days, you know, before the exam day comes, okay? And during those 2 days, you freak out a little bit because you're like, oh my gosh, you know, have I revised? Have I done this right? Have I done that right? You are going to be doing a perfect job of whatever this is, okay? That's what spirit wants to let you know, all right? You're going to come out proud as a peacock, okay? Nine of Pentacles also mostly features a peacock, you know, in the tarot. Now, I'm going to get you some oracle as well, for advice. Spirit, what advice do you have for pile one? We have yin and yang, and we have journey. Okay, yin and yang, journey. And financial constraints. See, honestly, guys, for a lot of you, I am getting here with what spirit wants to let you know is that I think your financial constraints, like, you might have had problems with respect to finances, okay? It's been a long journey, but it's coming into some sort of a completion now, okay? You are either getting into a partnership where you're going to be very abundant, okay, or you know, you are basically, this any area where you've been feeling lack, okay, whether it's finances or emotions or whatever area you're feeling lack in, for some time now, okay, that is now being added onto you, okay? Like, spirit is going to replenish you, okay? You are going to come out feeling very, like I said, very proud, very accomplished, very complete. For some of you, I am sensing like this might be something to do with a connection, okay? Very deep soul connection. Maybe it's been a journey, you know, to get to union here, okay? Oh my gosh, I just noticed I got two, and then this is 13, which is 4, okay? Which is 4. You know, so any area that you have, you know, faced lack in for quite a long time, That area is now coming into big abundance. Pile number one. Okay, so if you're worried that, oh my gosh, it's not gonna turn out well, this and that, no guys, that's not the case at all. Your journey is coming into a completion, it's coming into a union, whether that's with respect to a love connection or finances or career, like apply it as it fits. All right, like yin yang is a very, like, honestly, another message I'm getting here is that your energies right now are extremely balanced. Okay, they're very balanced and perfect for partnerships, whether they are, you know, like related to love or business or, you know, romantic or platonic. And once this completion, once you are partnered, okay, then I am seeing a beautiful journey is going to begin. Okay, all of this is 2-2-2, so I do sense in the next 2 days, weeks or months, something very beautiful, very spiritual, very calming, very serene is starting off. A brand new phase of your life is starting, a brand new cycle is starting with a partner, a significant partner. Okay, for a lot of you, this might even be a twin. Okay, twin flame or a very, very close bond with someone. Okay, that journey is going to start now. This is what spirit is saying. 2 is the number to watch out for. Okay, so to recap, I got victory at the at the top of the deck. You are becoming victorious. This is what I was getting. You know, whatever this is that you're contemplating, going a little bit, you know, fretting. I would say you're not like really upset. I just feel your cold feet and fretting. You are going to come up victorious here. Okay, so just like, I don't know, keep yourself positive, guys. Keep yourself positive. It's coming in fast, victory. You know, a beautiful journey with a partner. Okay, a beautiful phase of your life where you're going to feel complete, abundant, proud, good looking. All of this is coming. Okay, so during this waiting time, just go with your feelings and trust that the divine is going to make this a huge success, whatever this is. Okay, so that's all I have for you guys. Pile 1, bye. Okay, so pile number 2 with the clear quartz. What message does spirit have for you today? Let's have a look. Spirit, what is your message for pile number 2 today? Okay, we have 6 of Swords, Page of Swords, okay, 10 of Swords, okay, all swords here, lot of thinking going on, King of Wands at the bottom, and at the top we have 8 of Cups. Okay, let me just clarify these energies, then we'll start. Spirit, please clarify 6 of Swords. Three of Swords. Page of Swords, 8 of Swords. All of them are swords. My God, like what? Anyways, a lot of mental energy. Okay, and the Knight of Pentacles. Okay. I'm going to clarify the Eight of Cups. Please clarify Eight of Cups. Death. Please clarify King of Wands. Queen of Wands. Okay, all right. Six of Cups. Okay. See, guys, I don't know. This might be about a connection. Okay, maybe for some of you, I feel you guys are married. Okay, and if not, then this has been like I'm seeing counterparts here, King of Wands and the Queen of Wands. There has been some sort of a heartbreak and ending here, okay, between both two people. It's possible that there are tempers that are rising or are there, okay. And I do feel that there has been some sort of a breakup, okay, with the Death card here and Eight of Cups. And the breakup might have happened like in the past, I feel, okay. Maybe 4 or 8 months back, okay. And now spirit wants you to know that now you are like in the coming future, you are finally walking away from the impact or the effects of that breakup, okay. I do sense both of you guys are still a little bit, you know, like irritated or fired up with each other. Okay, however, this energy is like, you know, in the subconscious. All right, you are going to walk away from this big change or death process that has happened, I think, for a lot of you with respect to a connection. Okay, now this could be a romantic connection, a marriage, or it could even be a platonic one, a family connection or connections. Okay, if you guys are like, let's just take an example, if you guys are in like a dispute, like a divorce or something, some divorce settlement or something, this is finally happening. You are finally walking away from that and ending this whole thing, okay, whatever this is. Big transformation coming in, not coming in, I think the transformation has already happened, the death has already happened, and now you're on the way to healing from it and walking away from whatever this ending was that happened. Okay, so that's one. Now going forward, I am getting that for some time, maybe 6 months, 3 months, you guys will be healing, okay, from heartbreak, because like I do sense that there has been some sort of a, I don't know, some dispute and breakup and ending in a connection, okay, romantic or platonic. All right, and obviously it's painful, right? It has caused a heartbreak here, perhaps to both of you, okay. But since we're focusing on you here, I am getting that, you know, in the next few, maybe 6 weeks or 6 months, you will be healing slowly and steadily from this heartbreak. Okay, you are moving into calmer waters. Slowly, as time goes by, your heartbreak is going to keep decreasing. Okay, so if at this time you feel as though nothing will work, life is gloomy, it's dull, nothing will happen, let me just, like, you know, some of you might even be having very negative thoughts, such as like, you know, I don't want to live anymore, or you know, things like that, spirit is coming in to say that you will heal from this, and no, it's not gonna take very long. Okay, right now you're feeling like, you know, very lonely and sad and heartbroken, but you are going to move forward. You guys are resilient people. You are like King of Wands or Queen of Wands. Okay, you guys are like very strong inside. All right, so you will cross this time. Okay, right now the second message I'm getting over here is to stop seeking information. Alright? Like with the Page of Swords is, you know, someone who keeps a watch out. And look at this owl also. You know, he's constantly, you know, on the lookout for information, very guarded, you know, and all of this, either the information or just your own fears, might be trapping you in some way, you know, like overthinking, into overthinking. You know, the typical thing I'm getting over here is that, you know, oh my gosh, you know, like what if this happens? What if that person comes in and says this? Or what if this person takes this action? What should I do? I should hit back. Should I hit back? Should I be calm? You know, like all of those, like, you know, overthinking. This is all overthinking. Spirit is asking you not to be so guarded. You know, the worst is over is what I'm hearing. Okay, the worst is over. Even your stone is clear quartz. Things are clearing up. Okay, your head will be clearing up. I think you are very mentally upset. You're into mental overdrive pile two. Okay, thinking up all kinds of things, and I'm not blaming you. You know, like when a person is heartbroken, we do tend to think all kinds of things. You know, we are scared, we tend to think all kinds of negative things and this and that. All right, Spirit is just telling you to try as much as possible to put a cap on your fears. Okay, if you guys are, like, let's just take an example. If you guys are you know, like maybe looking at someone or trying to gain information about someone through their social media, through friends or this and that, please don't do that, okay? Because that's really increasing the problem, okay? Just let go, all right? Do not get trapped in what happened in the past, why it happened, how it happened, why did it happen to me, blah, blah, okay? Like this is a typical... I mean, this might come up, I feel, because this is a part of healing. But what Spirit wants to tell you is, as much as possible, stop, you know, getting trapped into your thoughts and trying to gain more and more information, okay? Either about another person or about the situation or just like about yourself, you know, in this, okay? Yeah. I'm also getting another thing. If you hear any gossip, please disregard, okay? Because it's going to trap you even more, okay? Let's just say you had a breakup with someone, and then, you know, you meet a mutual friend of theirs, and that person tells you something about that person, and there you go, you know, you get into anxieties, right? So Spirit is asking you not to seek any information, like just keep yourself blinded right now, okay? Because that's how you're going to heal. A total cut off from that situation, person, information. Right? Now the third thing I'm getting is that, see, something has been slow in your life. I'm not sure what. Okay? Like, I do feel it's been step by step by step. You know? And that slow thing is coming to an end. Okay? Now this could be with respect to this, whatever we talked about, okay, a connection, a relationship, or it could even be a job, okay? I mean, like, you know, I would put this scenario, I would plug in this scenario in any aspect. It could be a job that you have been working at that is now at an end, okay? It could be a career or a business that is now at an end. It could be a relationship, it could be a family connection, it could be health. You know, so what they are saying is that you are on the repair, okay? This long winded journey of worry, stress, anxiety, sadness, anger, frustration, all of this is ending. The sun is going to come out. You are going into a much more positive time, and this was essential for you guys. You are now stepping onto your soul path. Okay, like what I'm getting as a very strong message is certain things needed to be like phased out. Okay, I know it's very, I mean, it's easier said than done. It's very painful when these things happen. Okay, and all my sympathies are with you. Okay, but like, you know, when Spirit wants to phase out something, they generally do it for your good. Okay, because I am seeing with the Eight of Cups, you are now headed into something more genuine, more authentic, that will bring you much more happiness. You guys are going through a life transformation here, okay, by way of whatever this is that has ended, all right? So they're just telling you to be gentle on yourself right now. Please rest a lot. Do not overthink. Very soon, all of this darkness is going away. Step by step by step, you are going to emerge into the light. It might seem very dark right now for you, Pile 2, but you will emerge because you are rebirthing into a very different person. Someone who follows their soul, someone who's connected to the divine, someone who has decided on a higher self level to take the path of the soul, which will bring you a lot of serenity in the future. Okay? So right now, it's tough, but it's going to pass. All right? Please do not think, you know, really self-sabotaging thoughts. Do not harm yourself. Okay, just try to be as much as possible in hermit mode, or if not, talk to a friend, a therapist, but get yourself out of this, you know, funky mood. Okay, this is really, really low energy. Okay, you will come out of it. Spirit is saying that. Okay, you will come out of it, and you are going to go step by step into a very beautiful time where the sun will be shining, you know, on you. If you have any anger, if you have any, frustration, all of that is also going to pass. Okay. I'm also getting not to blame anyone, you know, if you can't forgive right now, just don't think about it, okay? Eventually things will work out. Right now, be gentle on yourself, okay? Now I want to ask for some oracle guidance also. Spirit, can you please give me oracle guidance for Pile 2? Wow, I had two dropping out. Adjacent possibilities and fourth chakra. Yeah, Archangel Michael. We have contract. Yeah, see, I am getting with this contract card, pile number two. I think you guys have ended or are ending some soul contract. Okay, I don't know which reading it was. It was a month back that I had done. That soul contracts were ending for a lot of people. You are not alone, Pile 2, okay? A lot of people on this planet are ending soul contracts which, stop the progress of their soul evolution, okay? Which stop the progress of their happiness. What has happened here is your soul contract has finally ended with a certain person, and now you are in the heart healing phase, okay? You are now in the heart healing phase. Let yourself be, let yourself relax, let yourself be very, very gentle on yourself. Do not blame yourself. Do not kick yourself for doing this or that, or think that you can do this or that. Like, honestly speaking, this had to happen. This was fated to happen. It was not your fault. I'm hearing it very clearly. All of this was not your fault. It was not even their fault. Okay. I mean, the situation happened, like, you could assign fault to someone here, okay? However, when things are fated, things just work out like that, you know? Someone, we think we can blame someone, but actually no one is to blame because this is fate. The soul contract is ending, all right? Okay, let your heart relax, let your heart heal. You have Archangel Raphael healing your heart right now. Invoke him, pray to him. Okay, and once this period is done, pile number two, you are going to have many possibilities, adjacent possibilities opening up. Like, many doors are going to open up for you in whatever area. Okay, I'm sensing multiple areas here. Okay, work, career, health, relationships, friendships, like, you know, in whatever area, finances, there will be so much of new energy that will come flooding into your life once you have purged out all of this. Okay, you guys are going through a massive life purge at this time. All right, it's nobody's fault. It's something that was necessary because it was meant to put you on the path of light and happiness, true happiness. Okay, once this healing period is done, guys, you are coming into a flood of beautiful possibilities opening up, which maybe at this time you cannot even visualize, honestly. Okay, but it is going to happen. All right, keep up the hope as much as possible and be very gentle on yourself right now. All is well and will be. Okay, so yeah, with that I'm going to end. Okay, bye pile two. Okay, so pile three, with the green jasper or the Kambaba jasper, dark green stone, what is the message from spirit for you today? Spirit, what message do you have for pile three today? The Fool, Page of Wands, Two of Pentacles, Crowning Energy is Nine of Swords, underlying energy is the Hangman. You guys might like to check pile one because I have 1, 2, 3 cards repeating from pile one. Okay. So anyways, let me just clarify now. Spirit, please clarify the Fool. The Fool, King of Cups. We had King of Cups as well in the last pile, in the first pile. So check it out if you want. Six of Cups, Empress, okay. Please clarify Nine of Swords. Four of Pentacles, okay. Oops. Oh, they want to fly. Okay, and this one popped out. Okay, Knight of Swords, right. Okay, so pile number three. See what I'm getting over here. See, you guys have been in, like, you know, some sort of hangman, you know, like a very stagnant time for quite some time now. Okay, I have a feeling with this hangman, I'm getting that you guys are in a pretty majorly stagnant time. Okay, and I'm getting that this stagnant time is now coming to a close very soon. Okay, it's possible it could happen in the next 3 days, 3 weeks, 3 months, I'm not sure. But something is coming in with a lot of speed, okay, to just like turn you up, you know, upside, this is upside down, okay, downside up. Okay, your waiting time, your period of stagnation is ending very soon. I do feel that you guys might have learned a lot during the stagnation time. But you also wanted to end now. Like, you have achieved a lot of, like, breakthroughs in your perceptions. There's been a lot of knowledge. There's been a lot of spirit communication even. Like, you have learned a lot. A lot of wisdom has come in into yourself right now. Okay, through this waiting time. And now all of this is at, you know, like, now that time is coming to an end very soon. Okay. So that's the first message. The second message I'm getting here is, see, with the Nine of Swords and the Four of Pentacles, I am sensing here that you guys might be a little worried that, you know, like everything is being hidden from you. You know, like with the Four of Pentacles here, Four of Pentacles is the card of like hiding, right? Spirit is hiding a lot of things from you right now, okay? And that's kind of like, I wouldn't say you're very worried, okay? I wouldn't say you're very worried, but you're like, you know, like a little bit stunned, you know, like this. Okay, you're like, what is going to happen? Okay, you're probably having a few fears as well, you know, that like, oh my gosh, I hope like something bad doesn't happen. Or it's just that I feel it's a very still time, okay? You are not being given too much information. You are hanging in the air. You just don't know what's coming in next, okay? But spirit wants to firstly tell you that this stagnant time, this waiting time is ending soon. Okay, something is coming very soon. Like with this Knight of Swords, he's literally barreling into this owl. It could be communication, it could be something, I don't know. Okay, but it's coming in fast. And the second thing I'm getting here is that, you know, like don't be so worried about not having much information, okay, at this time. Spirit is deliberately hiding things from you because they want it to be a surprise, okay? Yeah. Now, coming to the rest of the message, I am getting, see, there is a beautiful new beginning that is coming up, and that is going to be launched off by this King of Cups, okay? Like, I don't know, I really feel pile 1 and pile 3 are majorly connected, because there I was getting like the King of Cups, you know, in the first row. Here also I'm getting it, okay? So, I mean, either you are the one bringing a new beginning to someone, or someone is bringing a new beginning to you. Or it could be spirit bringing in a new beginning with this King of Cups person. Okay? I am seeing this as a very beautiful energy. Very benevolent, very emotionally mature, concerned, gentle, caring. Okay? A brand new beginning is starting with this person in it. I am seeing that you guys might have to take some leap of faith here, okay, in terms of like this. So let's just say it's a business and this guy is a business partner. You might have to you know, like join hands with them, and maybe it is a leap of faith for you. Maybe you are not people who do who are into partnerships. Maybe you've been solo for a long time or something on those lines, right? But they are saying that there might be a leap of faith involved here, okay? I'm also getting a sense of travel, okay? Maybe it could be that you are traveling with them, or they are coming to you, or you are going to them. There's something about travel here, okay? But more than that, I'm getting that this person is going to be very significant and prominent in your life in this new beginning that is coming up soon, okay? There is a new beginning coming up, and it's coming up fast, okay? You are going to feel very light, very at ease, very comfortable, and very looked after by this person. Okay, like I'm seeing this owl, you know, carrying this mouse. All right, so I am getting a sense of like, you know, someone who's very caring, always there for you, you know, like protective and things like that. That's the first message. The second message I'm getting here is, look forward to a message. Okay, I don't know, with the Page of Wands, this owl looks so intense. It's like he's gonna pounce on someone. So, I don't know, there is something about a very significant message that's coming your way, okay? That will have something that will be gifted to you or given to you, okay? I mean, it could even be related to a meeting, because Six of Cups is about a meeting as well, right? So, I am seeing a significant message coming in, which is going to hold something very exciting and something very nice for you, okay? It could be an invite to a meeting. It could be, I don't know, something friendly. I am seeing this owl giving something to this owl, okay? So this could be a gift of some sort. So this is something that is like on the horizon. It's coming in very soon. I mean, I'm getting six of cups, so it could be in 6 days or 6 weeks or max 6 months. But watch out for a very significant message that's coming through. Okay, and you are going to be like, it's going to make you feel very comfortable. It's also going to make you feel very, like, you know, happy. All right, almost, it's a very innocent feeling I'm getting. Okay, like whoever is sending this message is very intense, I must say. Okay, but the message itself, or whatever you know, happens after the message, is going to be very beautiful. Okay, so let's just take an example. If this is like a meeting, or you know, like even a message exchange for that matter. Okay, I'm getting that maybe for some of you this could be a beautiful back and forth message exchange, you know, like just being friends with each other and being very excited, and you know, like just like kids, you know. With this six of cups, I'm getting like a very childlike energy, innocent. So this is something that is going to happen, all right? And it might happen soon. I mean, 6 hours, days, weeks, or months, okay? Something is starting off. Maybe it's starting off with this king of cups person, I don't know, okay? But I am sensing something about, like, you know, a back and forth, beautiful, innocent message exchange. That's one. Second thing I'm getting is a meeting. All right. And the third thing I'm getting over here for you guys is like some sort of past life memories. Because see, six of cups is the card of past life for me. Okay. So it's possible that the divine will be, if you are into that. Okay. This is for people who are like very, very, you know, into spirituality. Some of you will be getting some very clear past life memories, okay? Beautiful ones, in fact, all right? So that is the third message, right? Now, coming to the Two of Pentacles and the Empress. I don't know. I am getting that you might be a little bit like, you know, caught off balance by something, okay? Like here you are being the queen, okay, or the empress, because empress is someone who's very confident, very beautiful, very elegant, okay? But you might get a bit imbalanced by something. Maybe it could be this message, maybe it could be this new beginning, maybe it could be this person or this connection, okay? I mean, this is all the stuff that spirit is hiding. I mean, you know, they're not telling me too much, okay? But because you guys are a little worried due to the stillness, I think they're giving some information. But there is something coming that's going to make you be a bit back and forth. You're not going to be this confident. You know, you might be like, what? You know, look at this owl, okay? He's like, what? You know, that sort of an energy, okay? You might become a bit imbalanced by something here. That's one message. Actually, let me clarify, like, what is, can you please further clarify the Two of Pentacles? Why are they getting imbalanced? So, High Priestess, yeah, something is hidden here. They don't want to tell. See, Four of Pentacles, High Priestess, King of Pentacles, High Priestess, Eight of Wands, Three of Wands. Yeah, something is coming in very fast. Once again, I'm getting speed. See, Knight of Swords, Eight of Wands. And this is something hidden. Like, there is a plan in action here, okay? And I have a feeling that you don't know, like, what this is, because spirit is hiding this from you. Okay, but when it's finally revealed, guys, you are going to be a bit like, what? In a very good way, okay? In a very good way, all right? But the initial shock is gonna happen, all right? You are going to be a little bit like taken off guard, okay? But you're going to be very happy after that. There is a lot of abundance coming. The second message I'm getting over here is spirit is like working. I'm getting like spirit is working very hard to bring you a lot of abundance, okay? Like you are going to be like this queen, you know, this empress, okay? You are going to be at the top of your game. You're going to feel like this. Like right now you're feeling like this nine of wands and hangman, but you are finally being crowned in some way. Like I see this queen, this empress, she's got a crown on her head, right? And so much abundance all around, okay? So spirit is like literally working like pillar to post right now to give you something very big which is going to come. And when it comes in pile number 3, you are going to be very pleasantly shocked, okay? It might come in a small package, meaning like it might come in like through a message or something, okay? Exchanging niceties, a message, and then boom, you know, like it's gonna happen, and then you're gonna be like, what? Really? You know, and then it's gonna lead to a lot of abundance, a lot of like, I don't know, like I see a crown here, you know. So something is coming up, some respect, okay? And it will launch off a new beginning. I do feel that you are going to have a companion here, okay? It could be a advisor, a mentor, a friend, a companion, a partner who's going to be like, you know, always there to take care, okay? So that you come up to this level, okay? You become confident. Yeah, another message I'm getting is there is a need to be confident during this time when this comes, okay? Like, don't be like, oh my gosh, I can't do this. You know, like, how will I manage this and all that, okay? Be confident. You can do it and you'll do a darn good job of it. Whatever this is that's coming. They don't want to tell me. Okay, I'm getting like small hints and tips, something about like some big respect or honor, something about a gift or some exchange of niceties, a message, a brand new beginning, and someone who's going to be very caring. Okay, so these are the hints that spirit is giving, which are going to come when the stagnant time ends, and that is ending fast. Okay, another message I'm getting here is that you guys, you know, you are going to look very good. Okay, I don't know, like maybe some of you might embark on some diet or exercise schedules, or even if you don't, I don't know, you guys are going to be looking resplendent. All right, this is what the spirit wants you to be. This is how the spirit wants you to be. Okay, and this is going to happen. If you guys are worried about, you know, like your looks or something like that, that's like going to be a thing of the past. Okay, so this is what I'm getting as your main message. Now let us get some oracle messages as well. Oracle guidance, spirit, what is the guidance for pile number 3? Yeah, for some of you, I also feel this might be like a marriage, because Empress is like a married person, right? So for some of you, it could be something related to marriage that might be coming up also. So yeah, for some of you, I feel there could be two offers coming up. Yeah, that's another thing. You know, like let's say it's a career and you get two really good offers. Okay, and that's another hit I got. Okay, anyways, guidance for pile 3. Ooh, not so much, spirit. Like, what is the guidance for pile 3? Oh my gosh, that actually literally flew off. Give me a minute, guys. This was the flying card. Okay, and let me get some more. Okay, contract. Let's take this. Shall we take these as well? I think maybe we should, because like this was a lot, but anyways. So we have contract, we have journey, we have man holding a heart, which is the king of cups. We have appreciation. I told you this is something about appreciation and envy also. Okay, what do we have at the bottom? The healer of the ages. Anyways, I'm just gonna take these. These are a lot. See, I am getting, see it's very clear, right? With appreciation, I am getting that there is some sort of appreciation coming your way, which is going to knock you off, you know, off balance for some time. Okay, it's very beautiful. There is something about a spotlight, success, appreciation, public eye. This is something that is coming, okay, you know, in the future. That's what spirit wants you to know. They want you to be confident once again. There might be people who might become envious of you when this happens to you. Okay, that's another sense I'm getting. All right, but you don't have to worry too much about that. All right, you are embarking on a journey. I feel you're embarking on a journey of appreciation. Okay, like meaning that, you know, you're coming into a lot of abundance, success, accolades, you know, appreciation for yourself, for your work, for whatever it is that you have been doing. Pile number three. Okay, now with the contract, I am getting two messages. Okay, one message I'm getting over here is that you guys will be signing some sort of a work contract. Okay, that's one sense I'm getting, and this contract might be related to some sort of this job, or I don't know, some sort of appreciation. Okay, some work maybe. Okay, and the second message I'm getting is that it might be related to marriage. Okay, because I'm getting the man holding a heart here. There might be someone coming into your life who will want to legally get married to you. Okay, marriage, commitment, that sort of stuff. Okay, because there is, like I said, king of cups and man holding a heart. This is like a double energy. All right, there is a significant love connection coming into your life. Okay, and this might involve marriage. This person is going to be appreciating you a lot. Okay, they really will be looking up to you, loving you, like literally having their heart on their sleeve in terms of you. Okay, so that's another thing that's coming up, which we got. Okay, now the third thing that I'm getting is there's something to do with travel. Okay, there is something to do with travel here, and it's possible. Okay, you need to, like, you might travel, either travel frequently for your work, or you might relocate for your work, or you might relocate or travel, you know, once you are committed to this person. Okay, so I don't know, I'm hearing pack your bags. Okay, it's possible, I don't know why I'm getting, you might have to frequently travel. All right, so yeah, maybe this, you know, this job or this level up that's coming to you, because this appreciation and the Empress are the same cards. Okay, there is some big role that's coming up, maybe a level up coming up for you guys. Okay, in the future. All right, and this might involve legalities, this might involve journeying or travel or relocation. All right, I am also getting that this will involve a partner. Most probably a romantic partner who is going to be, like, you know, supporting you throughout during this phase of your life. Okay, I'm hearing that they're going to support you, or rather encourage you to reach heights that you have never thought you could achieve. Okay, this is a big motivational force that's coming. Perhaps your future partner, okay, your future spouse. Right, and of course, you know, like, do turn a blind eye to people, because I do feel people, once you come into this sort of an energy, people might, you know how it is, right? People might get jealous or envious. Okay, they just want you to just, you know, like, brush it away. Do not think too much about it. Enjoy your abundance, you deserve it. Pile three. Okay, so this is what I'm getting. And bottom of the deck, we had healer of the ages, which is the magician. Okay, like, this is the divine wants you to have it. All right, maybe you guys have been very, like, you know, you've done, put in a lot of work, and now it's your due, it's your karmic due to get all of this love, money, appreciation, you know, like travel, like you're getting everything, guys. Okay, so yeah, and this is all of the things that spirit is hiding, so please don't worry, and it's going to happen soon. All of this will start off soon. Okay, so this is what I'm getting, pile three. I'm going to leave it at that. I hope it helped you. Okay, bye.